Thanks for checking out the Bakshali Method Calculator from MathCelebrity.com. In the next few minutes, I'm going to walk you through the Bakshali Method for estimating square roots and how you can use this calculator to check any square root using the Bakshali Method. So with that, let's get started. The Bakshali Method is a method to estimate square roots that are not perfect squares. And in this video, I'll demonstrate one example, and then I'll give you the link to check any number using the Bakshali method. So in this video, we're going to use 75 as our example. We want to use the Bakshali method to estimate the square root. So we click this button and we scroll down. So let's walk through piece by piece of the Bakshali method. First, we've got our number S is 75. Now the Bakshali approximation is a method of computing the square root for a number that's not a perfect square. The algorithm or method starts with starting at 1, and we square each integer. We're going to keep squaring until the square is greater than our number n, which in this case is 75. As you see, we cycle through integers, and when we hit 9, 9 squared is 81, which is greater than 75, so we stop. Our number then for n is 9, and we move to this part of the formula, d. D is just s, which is our original number we typed in of 75, minus n squared. Well, 75 minus 9 squared is just 75 minus 81, which is negative 6. So now that we have d and s, we're going to calculate p. We've got d, s, and n. So p is just d over 2n. Well, we've calculated up here that n was 9. So we take negative 6 divided by 2 times 9. We get negative 6 over 18, which is just negative 1/3, or 0.3 repeating. Finally, we want to calculate a. A is just n plus p. So n was 9. P is negative 0.33 repeating. And we get a equal to 8.66667. With all our pieces, we've got A, P. Now we want to calculate the estimated square root of S. So the formula is just A minus P squared divided by 2 times A. We plug in the numbers that we got from above, and we come up with 8.66025. So let's think about this. We found out that our number N was 9, because 9 squared is 81. And we know that 8 squared is 64 is less than 75. So we see that this number is between 8 and 9, which is what we expected. So really, that's all you got to do. I'm going to put a link to the calculator in the video description. And once again, you just take your number, pop it here, push the button, and you're done. I want to thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in the next video.